JavaScript variables and data types are a great way to store and retrieve data. Their primary purpose is to hold a value for later use. Creating a variable is referred to as a declaration. You're assigning a value to a custom name. Take a look at these two examples. Notice how the second declaration uses var while the first one is missing? In JavaScript, var is a way to scope a variable in a function. Both techniques are accepted. It's a matter of preference, programming habit, or specific needs. A variable must have a unique name, called an identifier, that you reference in other parts of your expression. In algebra, common identifiers are x or y. In JavaScript, you can get creative. Now for a couple of naming rules. Names can contain letters, digits, and underscores, but no dashes. The name cannot begin with a number, and it cannot contain a space. Names are also case sensitive and must be unique to avoid conflicts with reserved words. Here's some good examples you can use for variable names in your expressions. Here's some examples that will break an expression or throw an error. Many programmers use lower camel case to specify variable names. This format uses uppercase letters for the first letter of each word, but leaves the first letter lowercase to improve legibility. You'll find this format on things like thisComp or toWorld or even sourceRectatTime. Certain reserved names will have unintended behavior or errors, like using position as a variable name. The expression will ignore the variable and use the layer's position instead. A variable needs a value or a statement to be useful. There are many data types you can store within a variable: numbers, arrays, text strings, booleans, or even math operations. You can also store attributes that reference objects or property values within your project. Here's some examples of variables and the data they can store. By storing these values in variables, you can reference them at multiple places in your expression. Rather than typing out the same statement twice, just use a variable. Here's an example. This expression is redundant and very hard to edit. This expression assigns the slider to a variable and then creates an array using the variable for both indices. When using the pickwhip tool to connect a multi-dimensional array to a single value, After Effects will automatically create a temp variable for the single value and then plug the variable into the array elements. When working with properties and data in After Effects, you'll use a wide range of data types containing the numbers and values you're working with. A number, also referred to as an integer, is the primary data type in expressions. Most effects and properties in After Effects will utilize a numerical value. An array is a multi-dimensional value, encased in square brackets, that provide data for properties that use more than one value. Some of these values might include position, anchor point, and scale. The array values are zero indexed, meaning the first value of the array has an index of zero and can be referenced using value square bracket zero square bracket to retrieve the first index value within the array. An array may sometimes be referred to as a vector, which is an array of exclusively numeric data. A string is a way to store text-based data. They can store letters, numbers, symbols, or punctuation. Strings are contained within a pair of single or double quotation marks. The expression window uses straight quotation marks, but many text editors use curly quotes. If you edit expressions outside of After Effects or copy and paste from a web page, these quotes may need to be converted to straight quotes to avoid tricky expression errors. A boolean is an output of true or false. It can also be evaluated as a 1 or a 0. These data types are most common when using checkbox controls or conditional statements. Many data types can be converted to other formats. For example, a text string can be converted to a number and vice versa. Here's a quick overview of a few of these methods. This is a global string method to convert a data value to a string. This is a string conversion method to output a number as a string. This is a global number method to convert a data value to a number. This is a method to parse a string and return the first valid number it encounters. This is an array method that joins an array to a string separated with the specified argument. This is a string conversion method to output a string with array indices separated by commas. This is an array method returning a string as an array with indices split at the specified argument. We've arrived at the end of lesson 504, forming an expression with variables and data types. If you enjoy this expressions course, consider purchasing the paid content. It includes in-depth documentation, extra tutorial content, high-definition videos, and all the project files used in the training. Your purchase will help to create more free courses like this in the future.